Welcome, people. This is Spiritual Warrior Magistry, Royalty, Power, and Success in Christ Jesus. Today, we're going to hit you guys with a part two of what is the truth and how do we know if somebody is filled with the truth and are telling the truth. So, you shall know them by their fruits. You know, what does that mean? Are people behavior, the way they look through their eyes, their behavior, do they act upon, you know, the biblical doctrine, biblical principles? Do they act on the morality of the Bible? You know, do they pretty much, act what they preach, you know, or do as they preach? So it's really important, because these are the real Christians, and the fake Christians, like, it helps you guys identify which one is which, so you guys won't be deceived, and therefore. So I'm going to read you guys in the book of Galatians, chapter 5, verse 22, on the fruits of the Spirit, and then I'm going to mention stuff that isn't, you know, the fruits of the Spirit. So these are the fruits of the Spirit: love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance, and so forth. And it says that, you know, the people of the Spirit are also led by the Spirit and live by the Spirit. And they have the Spirit of Christ, they have the Spirit of God. So, for example, if you see somebody, you know, preaching the gospel or talking about God or something like that, or talking about Christ, yet they're spitting out profanity, yet, you know, they have a different lifestyle, yet they have an unholy lifestyle, yet they're smoking, yet they're, you know, drinking, you know, at the same time, you know, there's people that struggle with certain things. Yes, people struggle, but we can't be hypocrites. We can't be, you know, saying this and doing the other thing. So let me give you an example what's not of the Spirit and how you can tell about the difference between fake Christians and real Christians. And I was also guilty of this as well. So, now the works of the flesh are manifest. These are not the things of the Spirit. This is our carnal nature. This is living in a carnal mind. It says, which are these? Adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies, envyings, murders, drunkenness, revelings, and such like, of which I tell you before, as I have also told you in time past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. So this is a big, big way to find out who's a real Christian and who's not a real Christian. Some can actually fake it pretty well, but this is why people need the gift of discernment. People need to start reading the scriptures. They need to start reading the Bible. And a lot of people may say, why do you read the Bible or all that? Like, you know, like, they just, you know, If a person starts saying that, why do you read the Bible? Why can't you just come to church? Or you're misinterpreting the Bible. You have to be careful with those people, because those people are the most religious people and have the most demonic influence upon them, like highly demonic influence. As long, there's only so much you can misinterpret of the Bible. You know, be humble and let the Holy Spirit, you know, lead you, and be humble towards Jesus Christ. You have to want to understand what it says. Of course, there's parables in the Bible, and of course, a lot of people misinterpret, But some of these things, like the fruit of the Spirit and the things that are not of the Spirit, so you can tell who's a real Christian and not, are pretty evident. It's not like, oh, you have to think super hard to know what it is. It's basically telling you who's the real Christian and who's not. The ones that are Spirit-led and not led by, you know, carnality and, you know, and all these, you know, negative things. So that's a big one. Also, if people automatically represent a denomination or a religion, false flag. First of all, you're supposed to have a relationship with Jesus Christ, not a religion. Going to church on Sunday, however much you want, is not going to get you saved. You know, as soon as people mention their religion, false flag, like Mormonism, Jehovah's Witness, Catholicism, the fake Hebrew Israelites that are dressed like, you know, Power Rangers in the streets, claiming that, you know, somehow, you know, they're just the real Israelites, and they're bitter and they're cussing and they're doing reverse racism. You know, I'm shooting examples of each religion, and each religion has a different view of Christ. You know, they don't believe that Jesus Christ is God. You know, Catholicism is mixed with, you know, a bunch of idolatry. Mormonism, they don't believe that Jesus Christ is the Almighty God, neither Jehovah's Witnesses. They have their separate Bibles. They have their own rituals that they do behind secret doors, and it's all like work-based, you know, salvation. And that's not how you're saved. You are saved by grace through faith in Jesus Christ. And then a lot of them might say, well, are you not called to do good works? Of course we are. But it is because of the faith in Jesus Christ, or what he did on the cross, makes you obtain a different spirit. And that gives you the ability, you know, to show your fruit, to show good works. But good works, doing good works, will not save you. Because that's a different gospel. You know, they have a different gospel. And that's insane. You know, and we have Pentecostal denominations as well, saying, you have to speak in tongues and all that. I mean, there's different gifts of the Holy Spirit. You know, just because you speak in tongues doesn't mean, you know, you're a real person of God. No, it's, do you carry the presence of Jesus Christ? Do you follow biblical doctrine? People, I've read in Derek Prince, you know, book, a well-known minister, you know, in America, and he talks about, you know, expelling demons and all that, and he talks about something really, really intriguing, how somebody, the gifts are free, and the gifts are not gonna, you know, come off of you just because, you know, you start sinning. So there's people that are sinning, there's ministers, there's prophets that are sinning and sinning and sinning, and pastors that are sinning yet still have miraculous gifts still, because it was a gift. It said that Jesus cannot take that away. But this is why on that day many will say, have we not prophesied in your name? Have we not done many good works in your name, Jesus? But then he's going to say, I never knew you. So these are examples, you know, of, you know, these, you know, false religions, you know, disrespecting Christ, and how you guys should stay away from them. You know, this is how we test the spirit of the person too. He that doesn't confess that Jesus Christ has not come in the flesh, this is a big one, is a liar and an antichrist. Just like the Muslim religion, and we're not here to criticize any, you know, any Muslims, you know, but, and other religions, you know, and all that. It's saying that Jesus Christ is the Almighty God. And if you don't believe that, you're an antichrist. So that's another one, another way to tell of what is the truth, and how do you know if, you know, another person is telling you the truth. But also, the fact that if somebody's, you know, trying to make you join a religion, and all that. And you don't see any biblical, you know, principles. You see the opposite. You see them going against the Bible and what it says. Stay away from them, honestly. Pray for them, rebuke them. You know, we are called to rebuke those people. Rebuke them in Jesus' name and leave. You know, the moment people start forcing you into religion and say that this is the correct one, believe, it's false. Jesus said we must be born again. Must be born again. You know, meaning our heart needs to have a different spirit. His spirit. A Christ-like spirit. Not a religious spirit. Not a denominational spirit. Not a spirit of the devil. Not the spirit of religions out there. You know, but highly, the most I can say is just read the Bible, be humble, let the Holy Spirit guide you, pray for the gift of discernment. I mean, a lot of people don't have that nowadays. A lot of people trust just anybody just because they have a fancy suit. And this is a big one too. Do not trust anybody, no matter what clothes they wear, and no matter if they claim, you know, Jesus Christ and all that, because many will come in his name, as I mentioned in the previous video, and say and represent, or, you know, kind of represent him. And there will be false prophets, there will be, you know, false ministers, there would be nothing but wolves in sheep's clothing. I mean, sometimes people ignore their intuition. People ignore the Holy Spirit talking to them. They ignore the sensitivity of the Holy Spirit. Don't ignore it.